Coming up from Studio B. Well, let's do it now. Figuring out the next step in the battle for Iraq. President Bush kicking off 3 days of intensive meetings, getting briefings from the State Department in Baghdad. The president hoping, he says, to announce his new vision for Iraq by Christmas. With us now from D.C., Andy Grotto, senior national analyst at the Center for American Progress. Andy, I wonder what he can say that'll make things better.
Well, I don't think he can say anything. What's needed now is action.
Like what?
I think the place to start is to recognize, as the Iraq Study Group report has said, that the situation in Iraq is dire and deteriorating. I think the president still is not quite there yet. I'm not sure he shares that perspective yet.
Well, he said the other day it's bad in Iraq and that he's looking for new plans.
Well, you know, the question, though, is whether he's looking in the right places. It seems to me that what the president is doing now with this kind of listening tour of Washington that he's going on is trying to marginalize the Iraq Study Group. In other words, trying to kind of retake the initiative on the debate on Iraq and back in his own, circle.
I heard one person describe that Iraq Study Group, actually it was Britt Hume, as sort of a stay-the-course document.
I don't think it's a stay-the-course document. I mean, you know, that first sentence in that report is a doozy. I mean, it says the situation in Iraq is dire and deteriorating. And then it goes on to say that, you know, that there may not be a successful path forward. The challenge really is trying to find a path among less than perfect options that offers the best chances of success.
And, you know, I'm not sure that anyone has indicated what that best chance of a success is. The James Baker of the Iraqi Study Group was saying, look, you can't take this as a sort of a cafeteria plan. Mm-hmm. But then again, the president has made it clear he's the decider here. And you just wonder.
Well, he's decided he doesn't like it. I think that's pretty clear.
Well, you know, is there some political cover in this thing for him, though?
Oh yeah, I think my view is that what he's trying to do is marginalize the Iraq Study Group report, try and kind of retake the initiative on the Iraq debate. In the next few weeks, we may see three more reports on Iraq, one from the State Department, one from the Defense Department, and then finally one from the White House. And I think the president is trying to project an image that he is open to new ideas.
The question, you think he is?
I think that remains to be seen. For the last 4 years, he has shown himself not to be. One hopes that this new report from the Iraq Study Group, it's sobering, and that President Bush, that it's opened his eyes. The problem still is that President Bush seems to have this view that what's needed in Iraq is a Band-Aid. Really what's needed is major surgery. Iraq is on life support. There needs to be a dramatic change in policy. The Iraq Study Group offers one way forward.
And there are other ways forward, I guess, coming. And the president's going to give us a speech on all this, maybe December 18th. We'll see when that comes along. Hey, good of you to be here. Thanks.
Thanks. Happy holidays, Chef.
Thanks. You too. Coming up from Studio.